Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, it's Rift Gal. This is Ori and the Blind Forest. This is actually going to be our post-game episode. I've basically completed the game at this point. Except for the bottom half of Blackroot Burrows. Which, I mean, we've beaten the game, but we don't have one of the abilities still. There's this whole area, and there's those gates all over that I don't have the right ability to open. And from what I can tell, Blackroot Burrow, this whole area down here, it's an optional area, obviously. I mean, technically, the dash ability we got is completely optional as well, from what I can tell. So, I was kind of going back and forth about continuing on with this, because, well, there's lots of games to play. But I decided that I would at least do a little bit. I'm not sure I'm going to try and 100% the entire game or something like that. But I'm at least going to go through and do a cursory I basically at least just want to play through that area. So, I'm not sure which way to go first, but I think, generally speaking, the closed off area first makes sense. Oh. Hey, stuff that actually requires the dash. Hey, that's an unsafe zone. That was pretty terrible. So it looks like, oh, duh. This should be what we're going for first, because that's an ability. Oh, neat. Soul should cast our light. Even in the dark, she would see. Okay. Another full ability cell. That's pretty ridiculous. I'm confused. Okay. I'm not seeing anything that would really indicate what we need to do here. Didn't see what was on the other side of that. That makes more sense. That wasn't nearly as big of a section as I thought it was going to be. I mean, I realize it's not done yet, but it seems bigger on the map. That was kind of the guy I needed, wasn't it? Eh, we'll get through. Nope, we do have to go in the other way. Okay, well let's try going left. No, no, left was blocked off. Thought I tried doing something like that. Oh well. I am. At least I thought I was. So this is, that was the home where Naru grew up, it looks like. Neat. I kind of want to go figure out how to get over here while I'm in the area. Higher, maybe? Like down and around somewhere? Or not. Okay. Well, I suppose the good news is it's near a well. So I can always come back. Aha. That's right. Okay. So, I believe that's the majority of the actual game. Like, there's no other new areas for us to explore. is gonna drive me crazy. Is it that? Because it looks like it's colored in. Okay, whatever. Well, there's part of it, accidentally. But considering how hidden that is, I'm not expecting to be able to find what I'm looking for. Is that after I did that? Yes. This part. Actually, that's closer to a different area, so rather than walk the whole way. Hey! It shows where the remaining ones are on the map now. Specifically abilities now. Nice. Ooh! Okay, so we're gonna go kind of up and over here. Thank you. I'm not quite sure what the point of that is. It seems like I can go over here. I love making Ori swim upside down. Ori is adorable. Hey, Valley of the Wind, 100%. We have one 100% score. I think this one's gonna be next. Or at long last. Stupid spider one. Is that even? I smashed the wall and now I don't know. Okay, whatever. Sure, we'll head up this way. Thank you. Okay. Okay, so now we should have the life marker showing up too. Yep. Which I don't think we're missing that many of them. It's gotta be somewhere. Is it on this side? I bet it's on that side. Yeah. Nice. So down through, and that's the spider one that I've been trying to get for, you know, since the beginning. Oops. Okay. Finally got that. Then down. I guess maybe it's I'm not sure where the actual key is for that. Be able to get past that first door. That's really frustrating. This didn't even require the torch this whole time. Let's see. Are there any other ability ones left that I can grab theoretically? Bottom of Blackroot Burrows, which I don't know how to get to. So my thought process right now, really? Misty. My thought process right now is that I would. I'm considering going for. Maybe not the 100%, but just to get the. I would like to get the abilities capped off. And just kind of get the full game explored as much as I can. Let's go for this one, so. That was terrible. Oh, I was just chilling in front of a laser, apparently. Good to know. Oh, this area. I remember now. That was the last life cell. No, it doesn't tell. I did not tell it to dash at that spider. Okay, and seeing any there we go. It's really out of the way, but it's there. Okay. I mean, I guess. Is that all we have left? Is that one little energy spot in Moongrotto? Let's do that quick. Nope. Figures. Okay. Basically, just go west until we get. This feels appropriate. We're gonna basically end with the beginning. I feel like at this point almost everything else that's wet or that's left is either very well hidden or not worth it or both. Not that most of the things I've been tracking down are worth it. I'm just, this is just kind of my last little hurrah. I finished exploring things. I'm going back and just kind of getting the things that I feel like. The things I'd been looking, or I'd been trying to figure out how to get for a while. Stuff like that. There's a feeling of accomplishment that comes with that in Metroidvania games, of just getting the things that you've been trying to figure out how to get.
Thank you.
Okay. So the last ability that we just got is what is it actually called? Sense, which shows hidden areas. So that actually maxes out all my stuff. I'm pretty sure I've got all of the... I might be missing one blue upgrade. Oh, there's the 99% for Moon Grotto. Maybe. Yeah. So I'm gonna do two more things quick, I think. First one is I'd like to go down back down to the Lost Grove. See if I can get that last secret area now that I can automatically detect secret areas. Partially just because I want to see what the secret areas look like in this, or with this power. Seriously? I just wanted to get these. Doesn't like... See through walls to find hidden areas. Yeah. That's like barely noticeable. So this entire area has a underwater thing? Okay. So I think we're gonna call it there just because well, yeah, I think we're gonna call it there. And I guess those two are close. That one's okay, so I've at least located where they are, so. This episode's already long. I think this could actually wrap up pretty quick, so Sorrow Pass. Okay, 33 out of 33. Apparently I am going for 100% without realizing it, because I thought you, for 100% you had to get 100% on each map, but it looks like to get 100% you actually just need to get all of the collectibles, possibly? So I think if I get this and the last map piece, then we might be in good shape. This is gonna be annoying, isn't it? Let's do it. We're so close. So I'm not sure whether this is connected here or here. I'm guessing here. I'm guessing that this is a lava pool that we can get rid, that we can have go down somehow. It's also possible that something, or that the stuff we have, I remember this part now. I'm not sure what just happened there. That time I was sure what happened. I got squished. There we go. Still 99%. You know what? We got all the map stones, we got all the items, we've got all the abilities unlocked. The only thing that we technically have left at this point would be just map coverage and those stupid little yellow orbs, which will do nothing for us. So I'm gonna call this a victory. At that point, it's nitpicking. So, hopefully you've enjoyed Ori and the Blind Forest. I know I really have. This game is great. And last little world tour to kind of get to play around, explore the last area. Little bit of story stuff, which really didn't add that much, in my opinion. And max out, I mean, we took this tree all the way from here to here in this session. Although I will say, the sensibility really kind of sucks. I wish it showed it on the map instead of the way it is. Anyway, so yeah, this was a productive last little adventure. Got pretty much maxed out in every way we can, except for map coverage. So I'm gonna call it a win. Hopefully you enjoyed as much as I have. If you did, please give me a like and subscribe. Check out the other content on my channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments, especially if you have suggestions for other games you'd like to see played. I can't make any promises, but knowing what other people want to see helps me decide what I like to play next. I like to play things that people like to watch. And with that, have a good one, and we'll catch you next time.